Earphones.
All right, we're live, guys.
What is up?
Yo, 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 Flare Fishing fam. What up? We got, I don't think it's going to work. We got Alex Perrick, AP Bassin, Gene Jensen, Fluke Master, Noah Pescatelli from Kicking Their Bass TV. There he is right there. And then me, I'm right over here.
Fam.
How do I? Oh, mute your YouTube, yeah, and I gotta mute mine.
Yep, I gotta mute my YouTube. Hang on.
Yep. Master, no tech.
Oh, something is. Hang on. I apologize.
Oh, I gotta go on YouTube to see the comment.
There, that was my bad, guys.
I gotta mute it.
All right. So who wants to start us off here? Gene, you wanna go?
All right, guys. Give me a second.
There. That was my bad
one. All right. Hold on, I'm having technical difficulties.
Yeah, mine's kind of glitchy. You're live. So hang on, guys. Yeah, we're live.
Cool.
There we go. All right, guys, just a reminder, keep it clean, clever, and classy in the comment section, please. Otherwise, you will be banned from the chat, which I don't want to do because that's not the fun of this. So be nice to everybody, and we'll have a good time. All right, who wants to start? Are we going to do introductions? AP Bassin, who are you?
My name is AP Bassin. I like to fish, and my YouTube channel is AP Bassin. Okay, I'm just kidding. Okay. My name is Alex Farrick. I have a YouTube channel called AP Bassin. I sometimes post on it. I go to school at the University of Alabama. I fish the Opens, the Rayovacs, high school. Well, I used to fish high school stuff, fish college stuff now, weekend stuff, a lot of tournaments. That's pretty much me.
All right, Noah, you want to go?
I'm still in high school. I'm a senior in high school right now, so it's my last year fishing like the high school trail. My channel's name is Kicking Their Bass TV. I know some of you guys know me, but not nearly as much. I only have half of Andrew's subscribers, but pretty much going to be going to college next year and just really pumped for that. But I make a lot of tutorial videos, a lot of action videos, pond videos, a little bit of everything. That's about it.
Gene?
Hold on just a second. I got to get all my technical crap messed up. I yanked my mouse out of the back of my camera.
Chase?
So, let's see. You can hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. I guess I'm Gene Jensen. They call me the Fluke Master. I just teach people how to fish and have some kind of a good-sized YouTube channel. And a little something about Noah. Noah, didn't you get a full scholarship for fishing?
I'm going to be going there 4 years. I can't say what I got. But.
Okay, well, anyway, so he got accepted to SCAD, which is the, what is it called, Savannah College of Art and Design, going to be going through business school, so we're pretty proud of him. That's pretty cool. He's going to be fishing with them full time.
I'll have a lot more time once I
go to college.
Can I answer one question that keeps on coming up?
Yeah, go ahead. Yep,
go ahead.
Where is John? John is sleeping. Okay.
Yeah. So for everybody asking, where's One Rod? Where's John? The guys we stream with often. John was supposed to be on. He got caught up with some work, some videos, whatever his deal is. It happens. Been there. One Rod. I don't know if he was in New Jersey earlier yesterday. I don't know if he's still there. Either way, he's out fishing. He's busy. So it's nothing against them, guys. We didn't exclude John or One Rod. They were just busy. They had prior obligations. So just going to clear the air on that.
Yep, we had to go with the B team.
Go with the B team. Way to make them feel special, their team.
I told you I was going to rip on you guys all day. I'm sorry.
The A-plus team.
Yeah, no, we want to give everybody an opportunity to meet everybody. I mean, all the top guys on YouTube, all the ones that are doing it right or you know, where things are finally starting to grow and just give them opportunity to introduce themselves to our fans. You know, to today it's Andrew's fans, next time it'll be mine, and so on and so forth. So that's kind of what we do. But I'm trying to figure out what Andrew's doing. Oh, he's sitting
trying to figure out my camera. I'm going to try to set my computer down so it's not so shaky.
Oh, okay.
There we go. Sorry for all the shakiness.
Andrew, you need to get this this little stand that I have.
For what?
Turn Mac.
Okay.
I will show you. I'll send you a picture of it after this.
Okay. All right. Now.
And Tyler's going to be a little bit late.
Oh, yeah. He's running Tyler late. Anderson, if you guys are asking, he's busy right now, but he'll jump on when he's available.
Yep. And Gene the Goat and a bunch of other novices.
Hey, I'll take that as a compliment, all
right? Yeah, dude. Everybody's got to start somewhere. I used to be nothing. And so
comments are coming in so fast.
Yeah, you kind of have to scroll up and stop them.
Everybody just keeps talking about Alabama.
Yeah, I don't need that part.
It's better than Clemson. Who thinks Alabama's going to beat Clemson?
What did you say?
Who thinks Alabama's going to beat Clemson?
I think Alabama's going to beat them.
I think they're going to roll all over them. So.
Yeah. Just like that last game that they called a game.
Yeah.
Okay. What else?
Let's start with questions that, like, all of us can answer. Like, you know, don't make them super generic, but don't be, like, we'll do specifics later, but try to ask a question where, like, you know, we can go in a line, give an opinion. That way you guys can kind of learn from all of us and take little pieces from each of us. That would be preferred.
I got one.
Go for it.
For each of us, what is our favorite type of video to make, to produce?
There's Tyler.
What up?
Tyler!
I'm here!
Okay, we can start over.
Tyler, introduce yourself real quick, and then we'll get back to what we were talking about.
Yep.
All right, my name is Tyler Anderson. I go to Texas A&M University. I'm a freshman. What?
No Tide.
No Tide allowed. I'm, you know, still relatively... Okay, I've been on this for like 3 years now, so I'm not even new. But my channel's still, you know, somewhat smaller than the rest of these guys. But... I hopefully you guys like my videos, and I do music stuff as well, so I've done a music video, and I plan to do some more in the future. Maybe I'll invite Fluke with me, and we can tag team on the singing.
That'd be awesome.
but that's me. I'm sure my stuff is down below in the description, all my links.
Yep. Cool. Yeah, and the question is, what are our favorite types of videos to produce, starting with Andrew?
My favorite types of videos?
Yep.
I mean, I do enjoy teaching people, although, like, that's not my main channel focus like yours is, Fluke, but I do, like, that's why I'm doing, like, that seminar coming up in a week or so. I really do enjoy teaching people, but my favorite videos are probably the vlog style, like when I went to California, where I try to do some, like, tips and tricks, some fish catches, some music, just kind of day in the lives, just, like, really fun, more entertaining videos. Because it makes me happy, and it makes, you know, viewers happy. Just really just, like, I don't know, kind of more laid-back stuff. Nothing, no, like, tournaments. I like tournaments, but they're pretty serious, you know. They get me all wound up, and I get all stressed and stuff like that. So I kind of like the fun fishing videos. All right, AP, you go.
My favorite type of videos would probably be just, like, fishing videos in general. Alex has a huge nose. Thanks. Okay, but anyways... yeah, I love, like, fishing videos because I just hate unboxed. I don't know. It's so hard to make a good fishing video, and that's why I like it. Whenever you get it done, you're just like, oh, thank God I got that done. And move on to the next thing, you know? But, yeah, I like fishing videos. I hate unboxings. I hate everything else. But...
What gets me is why do so many people like unboxing?
Oh, my God.
I know, dude. I can't watch them.
Yeah, I hate them.
Me and Andrew and Tyler were talking about that. The other day.
Yeah. I don't get it. When MTV approached me a couple years ago about doing stuff, something with them, I flat out told them I'm not doing one of those stupid unboxing videos.
Why do people like them? I want to know why they like them. Cause...
Well, I guess it's just they just want to find out what's in the box. It's just like, you know.
Or it's just something to watch. I don't know.
I don't get it.
I mean, but... my thought is that kids these days have too much time on their hands and they want to blow it on stupid stuff. So if you put, like, $1,000 Tackle Warehouse unboxing, I'm sure you're going to get a buttload of kids that want to see you unbox $1,000
worth of stuff, yeah. Awesome. Noah, what about you, man? What about you? What videos, what kind of videos do you like to produce?
I'm kind of with Andrew. I enjoy doing the vlogs, and I know why people like them, because they can kind of follow. They want to see what you're doing in your life. They want to relate. That's another thing. I like making the pond videos, and... I see that kind of fun, just something to do on the side, you know, some pond videos, just to switch it up. And I think people really enjoy those just for the fact of they can relate to it, because a lot of kids, you know, some kids don't have boats, and a lot of kids are fishing from the shore, And so I think a lot of people like that. But honestly, like, my favorite is just going on the lake and making, like, action videos. I know most of you guys, like, Fluke, you do a lot of, like, tutorial stuff. Yep. I'm starting to do a little bit of tutorial stuff, but what I like the most is just action stuff, fast pace, a lot of fish catches, just a lot of angles, a lot of stuff like that. Yep. That's probably that's my personal favorite. But if I could go through, like, my fans' comments and likes and everything, I would say they really like the POM videos and the vlogs. Just yep. something to relate to.
Yeah, you do the just the fishing videos real good too, though. They're entertaining, so that's a lot of fun to watch.
Yeah, I love making them too.
Yeah, yeah. So let's see. Somebody keeps asking me to do a review of my Crocs. Anyway, Tyler, what about you, man?
Even though I've only done one, I'd say that the music videos are my favorite. I have some cool stuff coming down the pipeline for music videos. Since I got the new camera, I can finally, you know, I have no excuse not to do them. But that's probably my favorite. And then I do love doing tutorial videos on baits and techniques and such. But just having, you know, a GoPro has limited that because I want to get sweet B-roll shots of, you know, focusing in and out, which I was kind of spoiled to get, you know, a long time ago. But I'd say music videos are definitely my favorite.
That's, yeah, that was, I still laugh at that one.
Your parody. What camera did you get?
I got the Sony A7.
You like it?
Dude, it's sick. I'm still learning how to use the autofocus, but it's blazing fast. I mean, the clarity compared to GoPro and even compared to, like, the, you know, 5100 or 6000 is crazy.
That's awesome. I just got a Canon. I'm fooling around with it.
I'd have to redesign all my mounts if I got a dang new camera. That's my problem. That's why I haven't gone from GoPro to something different, because I'd have to, I mean, literally redesign everything that I do.
So, yeah. See, GoPro is just easy. You can clip it on, and it's...
Yep.
Do you guys see all the comments about me wanting to dab? They want me to dab? I just looked down the comments. Who started that?
I have no clue. That's funny. Oh, my favorite ones to do, you guys know I do instructionals, but actually my favorite ones to do are just me whacking them. You know, I just love to go out and just fish, not have to worry about video and just turn the camera on the back of the boat and whack them. But I got a little contest real quick. The first person that can guess what kind of shoes I have on,
oh my God,
I'm going to give them a Concept A reel.
Whoa. What the crap? You're wearing Sperry's. You're wearing Asics, Nikes.
I promise you nobody will ever guess.
I'm not got the Skechers.
Oh, we'll see them pop up here in just a second.
Everyone's seeing Crocs.
Yeah, that's too funny. I'll answer that here in just a second. But, dude, I really, you know, I love to fish with my kids. And so that's kind of some of the things I'm going to do this year is we're going to do some kayak videos with my kids. And that's the biggest reason why I'm retiring from my job is so I can fish with them on the weekends instead of work. So nobody's going to get it, so I might as well just show you. The Crocs are all but gone. I'm breaking in a new pair of shoes. And they're made in Hawaii. They're called Olakais.
Yeah, I couldn't have.
Oh, I was going to guess that.
No, you weren't. Oh, but they do. They're like they slip on and then the heel drops down and you can wear them like a clog too. So I like them. They're super comfortable. Tyler, your phone's loud.
Somebody tried to FaceTime me.
Yeah, they always. That's typical. So no, everybody was wrong. Sorry. Oh.
Someone said I said it. What are those?
Only after I saw it. Okay, let's pick some questions. All right, you guys stop worrying about my shoes and ask some questions. So let's see. Somebody said, Jake Thornbury said, Tyler, thanks so much for helping me get my high school bass team started. My headmaster is approving it right now. Thanks a ton. Just can't say enough how much you've helped me. Seriously, thanks. Good awesome. Stuff. Yep.
Okay, I see a lot of comments about being sponsored. Can I answer this?
Yeah, let's all answer that.
My thought on being sponsored. If you're not going to get paid, if you're not going to get something out of it, if you're not going to help this company grow to a multi-million dollar company, there's no use in trying to send out all these emails, trying to do all this. It's better to buy the product, show them what you can do, make some cool videos with it, show them to your friends at tournaments. it's easier to do that than to send a bunch of emails, than to just really care about being sponsored. Just don't care about it and just go fishing, especially at a young age. And the good thing about high school and college fishing now is you don't have to be sponsored by yourself. You can just join a club and they have Luz as a sponsor, Berkeley. All these companies help out us as young anglers. So you don't have to go out there and send a bunch of emails just to get a sponsor. All you could do is just join a club, join your high school fishing team, join your college team, and you can have the benefits and still help out these companies. And it's a lot simpler than trying to just be a sponsor whore or whatever you want to call it.
Well, I'll dive a little bit deeper into
that's
it
my too. Thoughts.
There's great thoughts, but I'm going to dive deeper. I'm going to say if you're getting a discount, they're making money on you. You're just a glorified.
Gene, you need to really clarify this. Oh, we lost Tyler. Hopefully he can get back in. Anyways, when you get, I don't even care if it's 50% off, they are still making money off.
You're just a loyal customer is all you are.
So when the soft plastic company, when the rod company offers you a discount, 20, 30, 40, they are making money off of you. Want to clear it? Go ahead.
And that's okay. That's okay. But just understand that you are not a professional. You are a promotional tool. And so, and I'm not knocking the idea because there are companies last year that made more money off of their pro staff than they did off the regular market. And so it's a very cool marketing tool on their end, just not so much on your end unless it's non-exclusive. If they only let you use their baits, then there's an issue with that because, it blows my mind. Number two is if you are worth the money, they will pay you the money. You may have to negotiate it, but they will pay you the money. And the other thing is a lot of companies these days haven't quite jumped on the bandwagon of YouTube. So YouTube may not be the best thing to do unless you understand the industry or unless you're willing to learn and fight your way through and get to the point where some people in the industry will help you out, will sponsor you because you're able to sell baits or sell their rods, sell their reels, their boats, anything. It's coming. It ain't here yet.
Yeah.
But it's
somebody tough. Just said advice for high school anglers, and I think people care too much about sponsoring, especially in high school. It's just like, my best advice is just go fishing. Like, have fun. I learned so much just by fishing with different people in high school. I met John, and I started YouTube because we went to the same high school, and he introduced me to people. I introduced him to people. We fish with everybody. You learn so much from just fishing with people. So just my advice would be to focus more on fishing with as many people as you can.
Yep.
Yeah, and one thing that I'm a huge advocate for high school fishing. I know a lot of kids come to me, for their questions on the sport. But I advise kids, if they can, to be their own boat captain. There comes a point when if you have your dad or, a guide of some sort being your boat captain, it doesn't really help you at all because they're not showing you, what you can learn. They're just showing you their spots. And so I had a boat captain that was not myself maybe two times for, like, official, state-sanctioned tournaments. And because of that, I was forced to do my own research, do my own practice. And so it forced you to learn a fishing on a whole new level than if you just have your professional dad take you out. Yeah. So that's my biggest thing about high school fishing is that you need to become independent in your skills and not rely on, your parents or your friends to let you know where the fish are.
Especially if you're moving into college, because that's not going to, you're going to really have to take over. I know Tyler's already in college, I've watched a few of his videos. He posted a new one. But, it's going to be a lot on you, and you're just gonna have to learn, and I think that's a big key. It's a good thing.
And another thing is that I remember when I was in high school when I started off, I would get so frustrated when somebody would beat me just because they had a better boat captain than me.
Yeah. And seriously, no.
It would make
that's the biggest
so
thing
mad, and I would nope. just be like, that's one of the reasons why I don't like high school fishing. But it just has to be there because we're not old enough to run a boat, they say, and it's just for liability reasons. But
yeah.
You're going to have to learn it, so don't get discouraged in high school. High school is all about learning. If you don't make it to the national championship, if you don't make it all the way to regionals, high school is learning. Once you get to college, it's a whole different ballgame. You have to do it by yourself. You're fishing against guys that are also trying to find their own fish. Sure, there's a lot of networking in fishing, but for the most part, you're not going to go with some local boat captain that's going to take you to some honey hole and you're going to be able to catch their fish,
Yeah, I'm gonna touch on that just a little bit about high school, because I was just like that. I used to get super worked up when, you know, there's, you guys would be surprised how many boat captains are actually like professional anglers. Like I fished tournament against Alex at the Midwest Open, and there's just dozens of pros there. You know, all the dads are pros, and I went to nationals against Noah. And Noah, how many dads did you see there wearing jerseys that like weren't like their sons or whatever, like that were their own?
Yeah, there's so many.
What's his name? I think Terry. No, shoot. Sorry, I forgot his name. His last name's Browning. He's a Live Target guy. You know who I'm talking about? His son was there, and he was the captain, and he's an FLW pro.
Yeah, Steven Browning.
Andrew, yeah, that's another thing.
And this I was like, are you kidding me? I have to compete against an FLW pro or BASS pro? Like, it's
so
just.
So you're out of it now. So you're out of high school. I'm about to get out of high school.
Yeah.
But the thing is, I think the people. See, my dad doesn't fish. You know, my dad. I mean, he's allergic to fish. I don't know if all you guys know that, but my dad's allergic to fish. He doesn't know much and really anything about fishing. And I think that's the same in the same boat as you're in, Andrew. Your dad doesn't fish all the time. You know what I mean? He's not like a pro or anything. So, I mean, once you go to college, I think it really helps you adapt and you learn a lot more, especially when you're having to learn on your own on some things. And, of course, other people are going to teach you, but once you get to college, I think you're going to have a head start on other people.
Yeah. When you get to college, it'll be – and then you can jump in the boat with some of the better sticks.
What do you think about that, Tyler?
And I can tell you that from firsthand experience.
How do you like it?
I fished three tournaments and did, you know, okay in each one. And then by the fourth one, I won against all the A&M guys. And so that just it creates an incredible amount of respect that they have for you as an angler. And now I'm the College Fishing National Champions partner going into the spring. So a lot of doors can open up for you if you, you know, become, you know, self-reliant and a good fisherman, which, I mean, high school fishing, I credit a ton of my success to high school fishing, but you have to be independent. That's the one thing.
All right. We get on high school fishing, not trying to end it, but that was a good talk.
Yeah,
it really was. That's why I keep the ball rolling.
You like college fishing? I mean, what do you compare it to? Like, what do you, like, comparing it to high school, do you like it a lot better? I'm sure you do. Yeah.
It's just, I mean, it's more chill.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I see what you're saying.
We haven't fished any of the, are you fishing the southern regional, Tyler?
Yeah.
On Martin?
No. I must not be southern. I must be southwestern or something.
You might be Midwest, Tyler. I think Texas is Midwest.
Yeah, I'm fishing Somerville.
Where's that?
It's like 30 minutes south of my college.
Oh, wow.
That's a home lake.
I get the home lake.
Yeah.
Nice. No pressure, Tyler.
Yeah, I know that.
What happened?
That's awesome. So no pressure. You better win.
That's right.
Okay, I fished the worst. Two times.
Honestly, I swear it's bad luck when you fish on your home lake against
stuff like that. Well, I don't know.
There was one year
that I finished second at both state, which they weren't my home lake, but I had some good background info on both of them. So, yeah. I don't know. It can be good and bad, I guess.
Yep. Blue Bank Herring Lakes, it's good. It's good to have a home lake. But, man, because a lot of people don't know how to fish them.
Yeah.
Shout out to Getting Some Bass TV. I see you all over my videos.
All right, let's see. What can we move on to?
Let me add one more thing that I learned
from
college fishing. If you guys have the opportunity to go to a different state, I would definitely recommend it, because fishing in the north is 5,000 times different than fishing in the south. Like, it is a whole new, like, it is.
I know, dude. I went to Minnesota and I caught 80 in a whole day.
Dude.
Crazy.
Fish up north are stupid. They don't know what a lure is. They're like, oh, what's that pink thing?
Yep.
And down south, they're like, oh, that's Jimmy's old worm from last week. I don't know what that is. Like, yeah. No, it's so different.
I'm serious, man. When I was fishing Leech Lake in Minnesota, I caught four bass off the same piece of grass in like six casts. I mean, I'd flip in there and get bit. Flip in there again and got bit. I mean, just it was insane. And all of them 3, 4, and 5 pounds. Just nuts.
I'm in Minnesota right now, actually.
I'm jealous.
Snow on the ground. I'm excited.
Yeah, I'll be up there middle of February. I'm going to the 13 Fishing media event up on Lake of the Woods. Going to go ice fishing. So
yeah.
That's going to be a blast. But goodness, I had a question for you guys. I'll remember what it is in just a minute. I don't know. Let's find another one on the
Noah,
list.
Noah, who's the other? Do you know who else that is?
Who?
Look on the bar.
Who is that?
That's just us kicking their ass. I invited.
Kicking their ass, man. I don't know. That's weird. It's me though. My internet connection just sucked, so I kind of kicked out. Went back in. All
right.
That is weird. Why does it show?
I don't know. That's Google Plus.
Is that AT Bassin holding up a shirt? I'll click on you.
Hey, there you go.
Hey, should we even touch the Lucky Taco Box versus Mystery Taco Box questions?
No.
We should touch that.
I don't see if there's a reason to, but if you guys want to do it,
let's leave that one alone.
Let's leave that one alone.
Okay, here's what I'm going to say. They're both great companies.
Yep, they are. They're both good companies.
I think they're both good companies. I'm not going to say anything else. I'm not going to say anything.
They're both a subscription-based tackle company.
Yeah. And they sell or they whatever provide lures that catch fish.
That's right. And they mail out on the same day of each month.
That's it. All right. That's all you guys are getting. All
right. I'm showing this off. You guys know what this is, right?
That's the whatever. I don't know. You and I talked about it the other day.
Is that a dial?
That's the Inception. It comes out in February. So 13 Fishing Inception, $120. There's my shameless plug for the day. I'm done.
Oh, jeez, don't give me that, Gene. You ain't done. Let's be honest here. Let's be honest.
I don't do it on my videos that much. I might as well do it now. So. Let's see. I got to get back on the questions.
I'm trying to find a good question.
What is a good beginner bass boat?
Anything you can afford.
I was just about to say that. Whatever you guys can afford. I mean, I guess get the nicest boat you can buy, but if you can't get a Nitro freaking $70,000 boat that they're selling nowadays, go get your 14-foot John boat, because that's what I started out of, and it worked fine.
That's what I had for a while.
Yeah.
I actually enjoyed that. That thing was awesome.
Yeah, if you're not fishing very big lakes with a lot of waves, an aluminum boat is perfect. You can get way back into stuff that you couldn't get with a fiberglass boat. It'll go just as fast. I mean, if you don't fish like Erie or some of the big southern reservoirs or any Great Lakes, it depends what kind. If you're fishing a lot of tournaments, you need to get to your spots quickly if you want to move around quickly, then definitely look for a bigger horsepower motor, save up. But, I mean, the difference between a 150 and a 200 and a 250, 20 miles an hour, and if you're not fishing tournaments, is not a very big deal.
Yeah, like I always say, you can't catch a fish going 60.
Yeah.
You know, and I fish out of an aluminum boat, and I fish the largest man-made lake east of the Mississippi. And it's 71,200 and some odd acres.
Yeah.
And so, and I'm on that lake just about every day if I'm not traveling somewhere else. And so it depends on the boat. You've got to get the right boat. If you're going to fish big lakes, you know, my 18-foot, a Pro 185 from Alumacraft, it has a one-piece hull, so it doesn't flex as much as the ones that have the two-piece hulls. So you can really get on that choppy water real good. But if you're seeing waves, like those 2 and 3 footers, you got to slow down on them. And because you don't have enough motor on the back to get over top of the waves. It's not the boat, it's the motor usually. So just get what you can afford. I mean, if it's a dang kayak, get what you can afford. And go fishing. Get off the bank as fast as you can.
Especially when you're first starting. I mean, you're going to need to learn a lot anyways. And start,
I'm going to touch on that too. I mean, fishing tournaments, that's one thing where you're going to need, you know, a gas motor, obviously. But the first boat that I bought, and I had it for 2 years, you guys, there's some videos I have on it. It's my John boat. It had a trolling motor on it. I didn't even have a gas motor. And it would go 5 miles an hour because it had an 85-pound thrust Minn Kota. It was a 14-foot John boat, and it was the most unstable boat ever, but I fished at it for 2 years, and I would pre-fish local tournaments in it, and then my dad would let me take his boat on tournament day. He would drop it off. You know, he didn't want me towing it around. So I would pre-fish in my John boat, and then he would drop off the boat tournament day, and I would fish the tournament, and it worked fine. And there was not even a gas motor on it. I mean, yeah, it kind of sucks going slow, but it cost me, I think I bought the thing for like $500-$600 used. Like, I mean, go mow a few lawns. I mean, you guys can get there. So don't let that be an excuse saying you can't afford in a boat, because you really don't have to get an expensive one. Plus, they've got kayaks out there that are pretty cheap. And I know, Gene, you fish out of a kayak a lot, so I'm sure you can you can talk on that a little bit.
Well, they've got huge kayak tournaments too, dude. If you want to get into a tournament fishing, I'm talking 200, 300, 400 boat tournaments. You know, and they travel all over the country, and it's just awesome, dude. And then the other thing is that if you live in a, like, I know in North Georgia, I know there's several states around the East Coast that have them. We have a lot of electric only lakes, and there are bass tournament circuits that go to these lakes, and they're electric only. You can't even have a gas motor on the boat, you know. And I used to, back before YouTube, before Bass Resource, way back when, I used to buy basically an old trackers out of people's backyards, add trees and bushes growing out of them, and gut them out and totally rebuild them and turn them into electric boats and sell them to these guys who are fishing these tournaments. And you know, there's tons of different ways you can get into tournament fishing and get the experience you need to be good at high school and be good at the college level. You know, you guys know Ryan Lamb, is Cinco 77 on Bass Resource, but he's the guy that did the bank fishing video with me. He's the youngest person ever to win co-angler of the year on BFL at 17 years old. Wow. And he got his experience fishing these electric-only lakes where his mom towed his boat around on a trailer from her sedan and would back it into the water, and he would go fish these tournaments and whack them. And that's where he got his tournament experience. And then he turns around, and at 17, he's killing it. You know, so there's so many opportunities out there. You just got to go looking for them, and it does take your parents sometimes being a little supportive. It really does. It's good to have a good mom and dad. So,
all right, I've seen this question maybe 15 times, so I'm gonna answer it. Where do I fish in Northern Illinois? To be honest, most of my spots I just look on Google Maps and I try it out before I had a boat, and now I fish like Lake Geneva a lot. Clinton Lake, just stuff around Chicago area, but I don't get to fish that much now because I actually live in Alabama now. So, to answer that question,
yeah.
There's people asking FLW or BASS for high school, and I don't have an opinion. I mean, I fished both circuits for 2 years, and I mean, like, yeah, you'll get a different experience. I think BASS a little bit more organized. Kind of depends on what you're doing. My state BASS was a joke. But the Midwest Open was, like, very well put together. So don't – if you're in high school, don't – no, I wouldn't say discriminate. Don't pick. Just do both. Why wouldn't you do both? You know, you want to fish as many tournaments as possible.
Yep. Like Andrew said, the Opens are so much more organized, and they're a lot of fun. They're really set up really good.
I don't care if it's Jim Bob's Tackle Shop sponsored circuit. Just go fish it. As many – tournaments, Thursday nighters, Saturday mornings, whatever, just fish as many tournaments as possible in high school. High school is not about winning, it is not about getting sponsors, and it is not about making money, it's about getting experience, because once you get to college, you are competing against very good anglers, and if you focus on money, sponsors, or being in, you know, the FLW or BASS titled series, you're going to get your butt whooped. So just go out, go fishing, and don't worry about it.
You know, yeah, the thing that everybody needs to learn is that the way tournament fishing is. I personally, you know why I don't fish tournaments? I don't have that mindset. You know, yeah. I like to go sit down and go fishing. And I don't want to worry about the thought of, you know, I've got to catch five, I've got to catch a kicker, I just want to go fishing. And I don't have that mindset of a tournament angler. And that's kind of what you need to do. If you want to be a tournament angler, you've got to get that experience, like Andrew said. You've got to get it.
I think tournament fishing is probably 99.5% mental. Once you get down the basics and you figure out your hook set, your line, your knots, how to use those lures, then it's all mental, just figuring out where they are and what to throw at that time.
Yeah. How do I start a high school team? Andrew's got a really good video about it.
No, Noah's got a good
video. Oh, Noah does. That's right. Noah does.
Noah's
Andrew's got a good video. Andrew's
a few months ago, I believe it was like 5 months ago.
Okay, so all the links. Sorry, I'm gonna cut you off, but I just want to say it before anyone leaves. All the links to everyone's channel in this chat are down below. So when we say, you know, it's on Noah's channel, it's all titled. It says Noah Pescatelli, and it says his channel. So I have them all down there. So go subscribe to all of us down there, because we all come out with different videos. Like I just said, Noah comes out with, you know, how to start high school, whatever. We got different types of videos. So everybody go subscribe to all of us, because you're going to hear us refer to each one's videos throughout this entire live stream. So you're just going to be lost if you don't subscribe.
Yep. Yeah, it's man. I wish we had high school tournaments when I was in high school, dude. I would have been in a lot less trouble.
This one kept me out of trouble, I'll be honest. I mean, like, I didn't really get much trouble in high school, and I didn't really, like, I don't know. But
yeah,
kept me busy on Friday nights organizing tackle. Like, it does. And Saturday nights, I'm busy unloading all my tackle, editing the footage. I mean, it does actually keep
especially
me out of trouble.
Especially YouTube really does.
Yeah, YouTube dude. Does, too.
I mean, yeah, high school fishing does, but, I mean, YouTube, for the most thing, I mean, it's a lot of work. A lot of people don't understand that.
People have did you see my green screen video? That gives a glimpse of how long it takes and how much work takes into making a 10-minute video.
I used to mess around with that green screen stuff. I did a giveaway once.
Yeah.
I was pulling people's names out, and I was going through if they did this step and that step, and I honestly, and I was stumbling over my words. I couldn't talk. I probably took 100 clips.
Dude, isn't that hard? It's not easy. Yeah. People think it's so easy. Like, I've never struggled so much in a video in my life. It's ridiculous.
Yep. You know, especially those staged videos. That's all I've done the last 2 days. And literally retake after retake. You know, get up, go turn the camera off, start it over again. I mean, you guys wanting to start a YouTube channel, you don't understand how much time it takes.
No, you guys have absolutely no idea. You have no idea.
If I had to guess how much time I spend on it, and this is without not including my full-time job, I work 40 hours on the weekends. I spend 100 to 120 hours a week on YouTube, you know, doing YouTube stuff, whether it's pre-planning.
A full job.
Yeah. So
if
you guys really want to do it, jump on. So.
Yeah, I wouldn't discourage anybody, obviously, because it's a great thing, and I didn't think I would be where I'm at today. But, like, I roll out of bed and I have an office across from my room. I get on the computer. I work. I get up. If I have something going on that day, I'll go do it. But, I mean, like, today I literally sat in my office for 12 hours just sending emails, editing footage, filming, just doing everything. And it's like that every single day. It's not easy at all. It takes a lot of time.
Yeah. A lot of people are asking, like, what's your favorite part about YouTube, and mine is honestly, to be completely honest with you, like the fan part, like when people comment on your videos, editing the videos, other stuff like that, of course that's fun, but the biggest part is the fans that support you, the fans that comment on your videos, the fans that like your videos, and it really motivates you. I'm sure they can say the same as well. It's just, it puts off a lot of motivation.
Sure does. The feedback is incredible.
Yeah, that's so, all you guys watching, keep commenting on all of our videos, even if it's just like cool vid, like all that stuff. You guys don't understand that literally it's all motivation. When I read through and I try to say thanks to everybody as much as I can, it does. If I see nice video, even if it's just literally nice video 25 times, that's literally enough motivation for me to be like, all right, what am I going to do for my next one? Like, these people are liking the videos. Obviously, don't lie if you don't like the video. But continue, if you watch the video, leave a comment, whether it's positive, negative, whatever, it's if it's about the video, irrelevant. Try to leave a comment. That way we know that you guys are really paying attention to what we're doing and that we're doing what we, you know, we're kind of here to do, which is kind of teach you guys how to fish and entertain you in the process is kind of how I think about it.
Yeah. All right. I got to respond to this one. Marilyn Bass Hunter said, try working in the real world. You have no idea what that is like. I would much rather do what you do every day. I have been in the military for 6 years.
Roast and fluke, let's go.
I have worked in a trauma hospital setting for 19 years. So don't talk to me about the real world.
I'm not going to say I've been in the real world.
I have held somebody's leg in this hand while he was over there.
That's
put it to him, Fluke. Put it to him.
Just saying.
No, I didn't. When I was talking about that, I wasn't trying to say that my job's like the hardest job in the world. But we're just saying.
It's a lot more work than you guys probably think.
Yeah. You guys think we set up a camera and I go, I like this lure because it's this color and I use this lure here. All right, done. Edit, publish. No, it's a lot more than that.
What I really don't get is a lot of people hate on. I mean, pretty much, there's a lot of haters that hate on stuff out there, but it's like we're sitting out here trying to put content out for you guys to watch and for our fans to enjoy. We're trying to teach you guys, and that's, I mean, me, Fluke, Tyler, all of us, we're trying to help you guys out. We're trying to teach you guys, and, I mean, for people to hate on it is kind of...
It doesn't. I wouldn't give them too much time, but it is what it is. It's fine.
It is what it is. Yeah, you're always going to get haters because when people see somebody successful, you know, they see your successful brand, they see, you know, how happy Tyler is when he's singing, you know, that kind of stuff. you're always going to get haters. So how many people dislike some of my feel good videos, you know? I have these feel good videos that you're like, nobody can possibly dislike it.
Exactly. People literally will click on your video and hit dislike just to dislike it.
Oh my God, yeah.
Yep. So let's see. Yeah, it is. Okay. Good. Let's find some good questions. I'm done with that crap.
Somebody asked what's my next video? It's gonna be on this thing. That's gonna
Hold it still. What in the heck is that?
Hang on, I got you. There you go. All right.
And it's gonna be Monday, so stop asking that question.
Cool.
Do you guys have a set schedule for videos? I know Tyler, you don't, because you're pretty busy with school. What about you, AP? Do you have a schedule that you can actually commit to?
Well, I'm trying to do every Monday, but that doesn't seem to be working.
All right, so you're once a Monday. Fluke, how about you? Do you have a schedule?
Tuesdays and Thursdays.
All right, Noah, do you have a schedule?
I used to do Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Sundays, but...
Okay, I am Sunday, Tuesday, Thursday.
And wow, 3 videos a week?
I've been doing that for 2 or 3 months consistently. And, I mean, I've missed probably like maybe 1 or 2 videos, but it's not easy. So.
Yeah, Mike's like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Mike has the life. He doesn't go to college and try to do this. This is his job.
Yeah, he's in the perfect situation. He's living at home.
Yep.
He doesn't have any bills. He doesn't have anything to worry about, which is perfect. I don't fault him for that. Yep. He is taking the perfect situation and taking advantage of it. So
he just better not have a kid. That's all I'm saying.
That's the one thing to screw up is if he has a kid.
Yeah.
You too, Flair. Don't screw that up.
Hey. Watch it there, bucko.
Goodness. Let's see. Yeah, Noah, we got to start. We got to fish Lanier together.
Definitely.
I've got 20 years. I told you this on the phone, didn't I? I got 20 years of waypoints for Lanier. So
yeah, I'm down.
Yep. All right.
Whatever is better. It's all muddy right now. It's 10 foot over a pool.
Yep. Somebody asked Flair, how are your teeth?
They're okay. They actually still hurt. I got a dry socket. I don't know if you guys know what that is, but that's like the one thing you don't want when you get wisdom teeth. And I got one. And I was in I was in lots of pain. And I had to go back to the doctor. On day five, I went back, and they got me like this numbing cream. I had to stick it in like a little hole down there, and it was bad. But they're just now I can eat pretty much whatever I want. And it's been over two solid weeks.
Yep.
It was rough. It was no fun, but I hope you guys enjoyed that video because I did watching it afterwards. I said quite the I don't even know what I said, but it was a lot of funny stuff, I guess.
Yep.
I can only for president was probably my favorite quote.
Oh,
I don't remember saying that. See, I remember saying some of the stuff, but like, I looked back at the footage like 2 days later, and I was like, when did that come out? Because I don't.
Let me tell you something. I wanted to hug your mother for doing all that.
Yeah.
I was like, I'm so glad that she was able to hold that camera and do all that stuff.
Oh, no, that was Macy holding
it. Oh, was that Macy?
She was the filming.
Oh, okay, well, I'll give Macy a hug when I see her. That made my day.
Yep.
I keep seeing a question about bank fishing. Somebody asked a question a little while ago about what's the best line for bank fishing. And, you know, the funny thing is fishing is fishing. Whether you're from the bank or from a boat or from anywhere, if you're waiting, fishing line is going to be whatever you want to use, you know. So I don't know if you guys have a better opinion than I do, because back when I bank fished, all we had was monofilament. So
I would suggest, unless you're fishing with, like, no wood or rock cover at all, not to use braid, because if you end up, you know, getting snagged and you're using 80-pound braid or something, you can't break your line down near the hook, and so you're going to have to cut your line. And I've had this happen before where I've seen kids cut their line near their reels, and so all the line is kind of just sitting in the pond. So I'd, you know, recommend fluoro or mono for sure.
Yeah, unless you're throwing a frog.
Yeah.
Or a topwater.
Yeah, I guess I've never really thought about that, using different line because you're on the bank. That's a good point, Tyler. I always recommend 30-pound braid to anyone starting. It seems like you can cast really well, and there's no stretch and stuff like that. But I never really thought about the whole breaking off thing. The only thing I would say is it's kind of hard to break off 30-pound braid, and so if you get stuck on a log or under a rock, a lot of times you can break it free. So if you're on a budget, you don't have a lot of money, and you're kind of pinching pennies to buy lures, I would suggest going with braided line because you can get your lures back, you know? I mean, it kind of goes both ways. It's kind of tough. Yeah. I like 30-pound braid personally. I pretty much just throw that nowadays. And
yeah, I wouldn't go over 20 or 30. You can go straight, pull it straight back, and it will either bend your hook or break off.
Yeah.
But
I've seen a lot of comments about, are any of us having subscriber tournaments?
Yes. I'm gonna have one, and I don't know, probably May or June.
Yeah.
I don't really have any details on it, but I think pretty much. Yeah, I'm going to try to get at least like two to three in 2016 done.
Yeah, John and I are going to do one, I think, in June, so you guys can look forward to that.
Yeah, I know. Go ahead, Tyler.
I think I was hoping to do one, you know, this spring when John, Mike, and Andrew are coming down, but I think we're just going to use that second day for, you know, another day of fishing and filming or, you know, competition and such, because I don't think it'd be worth it to do a subscriber tournament when we could make more videos.
Yeah, especially right now. I mean, it's kind of early. You know, you got all year to do something like that.
Yeah.
A lot of people are asking about cameras. Most of us use GoPros. I know Tyler just got a new camera. I got a new camera.
No, what camera did you get? Are you getting it? I gotta look.
Sorry. I got a Canon XA30. Well, let me get.
Oh, dang, dude, that's official.
Whoa.
That's like the official filming.
Yeah, he had to sell his truck to get that one.
What the heck is that?
Dude, that's legit. He's got that's what Travis from Lucky Tackle Box has, dude. It's like the real deal, man.
Looks like you're filming CBS News over there.
But the $100.
Oh my god, that was great.
The $100 question is, do you know how to use it?
Yes, trust me, I've been looking over it.
If you don't mind, how much did that cost, Noah?
A lot. I'm not going to...
You're not going to... Okay, here. Just
over, under $5,000.
No,
hey, it's under that, but...
Oh, okay.
Under five.
Here, hang on. I'm gonna put it in my notes in my phone so I can go look it up later, because that looks pretty sweet. What model is it? It's a what?
It's Canon? Canon XA30.
Okay, so I'll look it up later, no problem.
Let's go back to the tournament, or the subscriber tournament. Noah, do you want to have one this year?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, we'll do one this year. We'll do it like a Charlie Elliott or something. We'll just have to figure out when. It had to be after I quit my job. So it'll be after the spring.
Noah, your dad wants me to give a shout-out.
To your dad?
No, to Coach Payne from SCAD.
Oh, yeah, he just
he
got
said
on.
He's watching.
My boy.
I don't know who you are, Coach Payne, but I saw the video with Noah.
You don't know,
cool dude. Shout out.
You don't know who Isaac is?
Mm-mm.
All right, I'm gonna give him a shout out. Isaac, dude, I love you, bro. I was so happy when you signed that knucklehead that's down at the bottom of the screen.
Hey, I got one word for you, Isaac. You are taking all of my recruits. I'm trying to build the number one team.
Tyler literally texted me like a day after I signed or something like that. And he's like, you should come down to Texas.
I'm trying, man.
Hey, I'm fishing for my school. All you gotta do is offer me a sweet scholarship, and I'll be right down there for you, Tyler.
I'm working on it.
You just let me know. I'll be there.
Andrew, you got some good grades. Maybe you can apply for a scholarship through your grades.
My grades aren't that bad. I was like, probably a 3.335 in high school. That's not too shabby.
Well, out of 7 or what?
No, out of 5. And then I went to community college in the fall. I had a 4.0, but that's also a community college. But
now, what were you
that's
taking?
Not that bad.
Are you still going to school?
Me?
Yeah,
I'm going to university in the spring to fish for them. I just went to community college because they didn't do tournaments in the fall. They only do them in the spring and summer, and so I didn't want to pay full tuition to study because that's not why I want to go to school. I want to go to fish.
Yeah. What are you majoring in?
Marketing.
There you go.
Yeah, same with the rest of us.
Yeah. What? I'm not.
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
Civil engineering.
Ah, geez, son.
I don't know. I like it, but it's just hard. It's hard.
Hey, it's the old man.
Hey, Coach, Payne is the bomb. You guys need to take time to go look at scad fishing.
Yep.
Coach Payne is going to do big things. He's been awesome. He's been fishing with the kids. He's been texting up, talking to them. You guys need to know what a great dude this really is.
No, he's a good dude.
He's a cool dude, yeah.
He has
big dreams and big visions, and he really, really, really wants to bring some light to the college fishing.
Yep, he's one of the few people this last year that absolutely impressed me. I mean, I just was blown away by him. So, great guy.
Well, if there's anything all we guys can do to get together and just bring some light on the sport, I think it's very important, and I think that, you know, we'll set some standards, and all the other colleges should have something to follow.
Yep. Awesome.
Thanks, Luke.
Yes, brother.
See you guys.
I knew it was coming.
Power poles or talons? I would definitely say power poles from my
experience. Yes.
Because, I don't know, I've been in boats with the new talons, and they are so noisy.
They are noisy. I've actually never been in a boat with a power pole, or well, like they've used it. I've only been in with a boat with a talon. It's just loud. I mean, they work so loud.
Locked down, you're screwed.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah. They go down and they won't come up on the.
Yeah, they won't come up.
And the new power pole blade is like the quietest thing I've ever seen in my life. Yeah.
I have an 8-foot blade. Power pole is my one and only sponsor, mostly because I don't really care about sponsors right now. But I know that I'm not going to leave them for the rest of my career. So they were definitely a good person to apply for.
I like the power pole micro on my kayak. You know, it just kind of, you know. Oh, but anyway, yeah. That
Noah, do you have a girlfriend?
I prefer Noah's girlfriend over Andrew's.
Noah, do you have a girlfriend?
Or Ann.
You're not. Are you in Foshi?
Really, Andrew?
He just turned 3 shades of red, dude.
Wait, no, that's what someone just said. Are you?
No.
Oh, and then who are you with?
Huh?
Are you with a girlfriend?
Yeah.
That's like dating royalty if you date Shiposhi.
You're dating someone, Pescatelli?
I was last week.
What is this kid talking about? Oh my gosh.
Was it a woman or was it a guy?
Yeah, I guess we didn't specify.
Woman.
Oh, it was a woman, okay.
It's a set of 50-pound dumbbells.
College girl.
That's true.
College girl, whoa.
Wait, all right, are you officially dating anyone, Noah, or are you just like talking?
Oh, not right now, no. I'm playing. I'm
you're playing? Did you just say you're playing? I think you just said you're playing.
I'm playing around, Andrew. I'm playing around.
All right. Your girlfriend or mine? And I was like, oh, I didn't know Noah had a girlfriend. That's news to me.
Oh, and okay, I'm going back to the questions. Captain Chris, yes, the Inceptions are the real thing, man. They're great reels. Okay.
Let's see. Team John for life. No.
It's spelled John wrong, so it doesn't count.
Yeah, it doesn't count.
I have bushy eyebrows.
Okay.
Why'd you say that?
That was a comment.
Oh.
Oh, speaking of yellow
condoms.
Luke, I got a boom.
Oh, dude, that would be so sick.
Luke, do you like your boom?
No.
I love it.
I just got one. It was, 2 days ago. I got it in the mail.
Yeah, I'm gonna put one on the back of Noah's boat and let him try it out. He'll love it.
Nice.
Awesome. There's a question that keeps popping up, and I just lost it again. Dadgummit. I have the worst memory.
Well, it's so fast. It's like...
I know. You all just slow down on this comment.
Yeah, they're like... I'm trying to read one of these. AP Bassin, are you close to Niles, Illinois? I'm like 30 minutes from there. Shema...
My gosh, you guys are so quick.
Favorite soft plastics. I would have to say I love Strike King soft plastics. I love Berkeley soft plastics. I love Zoom soft plastics. I just buy whatever's on sale.
I was going to say, who aren't you going to name here?
Yeah, I'm just naming a bunch. I don't really use a specific soft plastic.
Right, are you ready for me to answer this question? Yes. What the best soft plastic is?
Yes.
Okay. The one you have the most confidence in.
Mmm.
That is the answer to that question.
Okay? Such a fluke master answer.
It is a fluke master answer, but it's a great answer.
All right, someone said spinner baits or fish head spin. which
depends on where you live in the country, because I've never caught a fish on a
two different applications.
Yeah, it's like fishhead. I fish out deep, and spinnerbait. I'll usually use up shallow if there's wind. You know, I mean, I'll use it out deep too. But if there's wind, mostly a spinnerbait. But I love the fishhead bite right now. That's what I've been catching them on pretty much. I mean, that's like the only bait I've been throwing really.
Yeah.
Right on the bottom.
And if you fish Lanier like Noah, you only need three baits.
Yeah.
Fishhead spin. Top water and a jig.
And a drop shot.
$5 here, biting top water.
And a drop shot.
Four baits. Tyler, did you see that comment? They wanted to know if we were in a frat. Are you in a frat?
No, well, I was for like 4 weeks, and then I didn't have time for it, so I dropped.
Yeah, I'm not in a frat either. It's pretty big in the South, but I don't know. Fishing is like every other weekend, and it's just like I'd rather go fishing than go party every night, so I'm not in a frat.
Right, hang on. I'm going to touch something. For the people using emojis, nothing more than one emoji, otherwise you're getting banned. I'm saying it right now. You're seeing the spammed emojis.
Making them really hard to read.
You get one emoji in your text, and that's it. Otherwise, you're out.
The dictator has spoken.
Oh, Justin.
I have the tip. I'm going to give you one more time.
Wait, no. See, you got to let him. It's delayed, so he didn't
get... I know. That's what I'm saying.
Don't be mean.
Give him a chance.
Okay, Gene, let's see.
Help me for winter baits. Dang. Fishhead
spin. Go watch our YouTube channels.
Yep. Fishhead spin, fish the ditches. You know, there's a ton of... My favorite way to catch them in the wintertime is under my fish finder with a dang jigging spoon. My favorite way to catch them.
Oh, yeah.
It's like...
What kind of electronics do you use?
What now?
What electronics do you use?
I have HDS-8s, Gen 2s. So my next boat will have probably Hummingbird on it.
Yeah. I'm switching to Lowrance.
Thinking about it. Wait, what do you have now?
I have an 1199 and an 858, and I just with the college deal they gave $1,000 off a Gen 2 12, so I got two 12s for $1,000 each.
Wow.
Yes. Wow. Because Tackle Warehouse had them like 20% off, plus the 20% off from Thanksgiving. Then I used the college fishing rebate. It was insane. I was like, I got to do this, so I just went ahead and bought them, and then I'm gonna sell my Hummingbirds, and I'll probably make a little bit of money off them and try Lowrance for a little bit.
Yeah. All right, I'm going to ask you a question. This is for all of us. Jake Thornberry keeps asking this question. I'm just going to do part of it. If we could only have one lure, I'll do all of it. One lure, one rod and reel, what would it be? A jig, a medium heavy, 7'3", and an 8 or 7-3-1 gear ratio reel.
What pound test line?
Pound test line, with a jig, it's going to be fluorocarbon, so it's going to be 20-pound test fluoro.
20-pound. I'll have to say, I'd say a 7-2 medium heavy. I'd say a swim jig, a half swim jig, half flipping jig head, and I'd probably use 17-pound fluoro and a fast 7-1-1 reel or 8-1-1 reel.
Yep.
Tyler?
All right, who's next? Tyler, go ahead.
I'm going to go with a 7-2 medium heavy, 17-pound fluorocarbon, a 7-1-1 reel, and a Santone Lures, I don't know if it's the casting jig or it's just a normal jig head, but it skips so well, and I fish so many docks that you just have to have, you know, a skippable jig.
Noah?
7-2 medium heavy, on a 7-1-1 gear ratio reel, or the Revo Rocket, which is a 9-1 gear ratio reel, 15 to 17 pound fluorocarbon, and a Chattahoochee jig. It's just a little flipping jig, skipping jig.
All right, not to waste your time. Same thing, except I'd use a New Tech jig for pretty much everything you guys said. Same pound. I wouldn't go 20. I'd probably go 15.
Yeah,
15 pound fluoro, 15, but 7-1, 7-2 medium heavy, and a New Tech jig because. I don't know. They've worked well for me the last 3 years, so I'm not – no reason to change.
Yep.
Personal best bass. I've seen that like 15 times.
Hey, I just caught a new one, 7.5.
7.5.
I had to go all the way to California to get it.
Yeah. I did have to go to California to get it. It was a good time.
That was awesome.
Mine's
– I half like a little girl.
Tyler, what's yours?
Mine is 8.9, but it had literally just spawned about 20 minutes before I caught it. So. I was sincerely mad. It would have been a double digit for sure.
Noah?
I've caught a few. I've caught like a 9 and a 10, but those are in ponds years ago. But like in the past like year, like a 7. I don't remember the exact weight, but like a 7 pounder on like a lake.
My biggest bass 6.5.
Yeah, I caught mine from a Hobie kayak this spring. It was 10 pounds, 12 ounces. So my first double digit.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah, that was awesome. What's even cooler is Hank Parker was right down the bank from me watching me do it.
Nice.
Yeah, that was pretty fun. All right. The trolls are coming out.
I got them. No
yeah, worries. That was an obscure comment.
I saw it.
Yeah, some people got issues. somebody asked me what part of Florida am I coming down to. I'm fishing Lake Okeechobee. I'll be staying at Roland Martin's place.
So, ooh.
Yeah. There you go. That's where I stayed.
I'm staying in the Econo trailers, though, not the expensive one.
All right, let's see. AP, the question. Okay, that was not.
Someone asked me if I know Lake Fork Guy. I live about 5.5 minutes from his door. So we've become, you know, really good friends. He gave me a, you know, brand new Shimano reel to try. I'm trying to get him in on all this YouTube stuff because he just makes his own videos and doesn't.
I hit him up the other day, just like whatever. But yeah, no, he totally needs to get in on this stuff because it's
so, a lot of fun. Eventually we're gonna get some live streams together. I'm sure me and him can sit in the same room with you guys and do live streams. But yeah. I mean, I live so close to him now.
Yeah, he's a freaking stud, man. A lot of what he used to do is what motivated me to do what I'm doing now. So,
yeah.
I'm going to Texas in the next 12 months, and we're gonna all hang out. And
you do.
I want to go to Texas.
Yeah, I'll pick you up on the way, Noah.
Yeah. Right. That can get me too.
You're a little out of the way. You have to be.
Yeah.
No, I'll be at school. I'll be at school.
Harry, do you go to Alabama?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you went to like Southern Alabama or something.
No, I go to Alabama.
Okay.
Like Roll Tide, Alabama.
Roll Tide. On Monday, Roll Tide.
Yeah. Let's see.
What's
your thoughts on braided line with a leader? Is that what you're reading?
Yeah. Yeah, we'll do that.
Let's touch on that. I know we've done that before in live streams. What are your guys' thoughts on fishing line? We'll just go down the line.
Really first?
Yeah, let's start with AP. Sorry.
Okay. I only use it when I'm using my spinning rods, and I usually use like a 20-pound test braid to like a anywhere from 4-pound to 8-pound test fluorocarbon, depending on what I'm fishing. I don't use 4 a lot, but mostly 8-pound tests. And you can feel so much more as long as you use a long enough leader. I don't think they can see it. I don't see it for bait casters. I just use straight fluorocarbon because it doesn't tangle up, and you can still feel pretty good with the right rod. So I pretty much only tie a leader when I'm using my spinning rod, and sometimes I will use straight fluorocarbon on my spinning rod. It just all depends, but that's how I feel.
Fish, do you think fish can see line?
Yes. No, I do not. Not at all.
Tyler, you have to wait your turn.
They can see mono.
I flip 50-pound braid under docks, and I don't think they can see it.
I'm going to go in the line. I'm watching.
And it's gin clear.
I agree with AP. I think they cannot see line, but I think there's certain times when the bass are really finicky. And there's all those days. You know, there's days where you'll go out there and you'll crush them on a buzzbait, frog, spook, anything. You can literally throw anything at them and they'll catch them. Then there's days when there's, you know, high skies, super high pressure. I think using not braid, something clear, it's just more finesse. And it's not that they can and cannot see the line. I think it just makes the bait look more natural is the difference there. So if you guys think fish can see line, I'm going to disagree with you, but I'm not saying it's not going to hurt to use a fluorocarbon leader, especially when the bass are really finicky. Fluke, you go.
I'm going to talk a couple of things that came up. Fishing line. If you ever go scuba diving and you have some buddy throw fishing line into the water, it's a clear day and it's monofilament, it looks like a laser shooting down from the surface. If it's a sunny day, it literally, you just threw fiber optic cable down in the water, and it looks like a laser going all the way down to your bait. Fluorocarbon does not do that. That's the huge difference. Now, I use braided line on my spinning rod, just like AP said. Let me try not to hit my ceiling fan full of Bill Dance. But a couple of things. I use this is a braid that's made in Japan. Shin Fukai imports it and sells it at my local tackle shop, and it's a sinking braid. It's not very durable. It's pitiful on durability, but it's a sinking braid. But if you're ever tying a leader to your braid on a spinning rod, you want your knot to stop right between the big guide and the very next guide. And what that does is it protects your knot a lot more. This is the guide that beats up your knots on your leaders, your leader knot. This is the one that tears your knot up. So if you stop right here and it's right where you're going to cast, or anywhere north of that, that's where you want your knot to be. I use an FG knot. There's a bunch of videos. I made one. Salt Strong made one. That FG knot is skinny, and you don't even hear it coming through the guides. And I use 4, 6. I've been known to use 2-pound test fluorocarbon, depending on what I'm doing, and never had a problem with it. Never had issues with thinking that they can see me. And Clark's Hill gets pretty clear when the hydrilla is good and thick. So, and then the size braid is probably 12 to 15-pound braid, not very big. It's kind of like spider web. You know, it's real skinny. So, but that's my take on leaders on a spinning rod. I use braid on my flipping stuff when I'm heavy cover stuff. Like, this is a new braid I'm trying out. It's from Cast King, I think. And I'm going to take it to Okeechobee and see if I can break it. And so my flipping rods and my spinning rods is all I use braid on.
Noah, what are your thoughts? Can fish see line?
I like what you said, how if they're really finicky, it can matter. I mean, I it's hard to really say. You know, I mean, you're obviously not sitting in the fish's face to see that, but I could say, yeah. I mean, say I'm throwing 15-pound fluorocarbon, I wouldn't feel comfortable throwing, like, braid out there. But going on leaders, like, on my spinning rods, I use braid and I use a fluorocarbon leader. Just, I mean, I feel more comfortable with that. I always use braid for, like, flipping and stuff. I don't see a problem with that. You know, in dirty water, I think braid would be fine. But definitely flipping and stuff like that, definitely fine with that. But I just feel as if I'd rather use fluorocarbon. I feel as if they do see it a little bit. That's just my personal opinion. There's no definite answer on that, but that's
what I think. What?
You're the one that said fish can see lines, so let me hear it.
Okay. Fish on beds are stupid. I'm going to go out and say that right now. But I have done a lot of studies with fish on beds because I've looked at them so much in my underwater stuff. And I have noticed a difference when I throw a Senko with braid than I throw a Senko with fluorocarbon. They're more receptive to come close and look at it if it's on fluorocarbon than if it's on braid. And yesterday when I was fishing a marina slip, I was dropping down minnows, live minnows, with braided line. And I wasn't catching fish, and my buddy Clark was dropping down with floral line and was catching fish. So,
You know why?
Why?
Because fluorocarbon sinks and braid floats.
I think that could be it, too.
If you throw a Senko on fluorocarbon, you throw a Senko on braid, it has a totally different action.
That is true.
I think that has something to do with it, too.
Okay. All right. In conclusion, this is the answer. What you feel most confident with.
That's what always comes to
every question. We're going to give you our opinions, but in reality, if you think fish can see line, then don't throw braid and use
I mean, I'm there with Tyler. I really feel as if they could. I mean, it may be in my head, but I feel more comfortable.
And that's the thing. If it's in your head, there's nothing wrong with that. Then you just need to stick to your confidence.
Yep.
Yeah. I agree. All right, I'm with my family here in Minnesota, so I'm going to have to jet out for you guys right now. All right. All you guys watching right now, check out my YouTube channel, Tyler's Real Fishing.
Links below.
It's Tyler's Real Fishing. Snapchat is Tyler's Real Fish. Periscope is Tyler's Real Fish. And that's pretty much all I got to say.
What kind of boat do you have? I keep seeing that. We should all
what
say
what boat do I have?
Yeah.
I have a 2000 Skeeter ZX202, so it's the 20-foot, 2-inch version. And I tell you, for a 2000, it does not look like a 2000. We bought it in, you know, perfect condition, used. The engine has had zero problems. It's been a great boat. It can go 68, which is, you know, faster than Fluke wants it. But I mean, I love Skeeters, but you know what? I've ridden in Rangers, I've ridden in Legends, and I love them all. So I don't discriminate against boats, but it's just the one that I have.
Yep. Sweet. If it floats, fish out of it.
Yep.
That's true.
All right. While Tyler's exiting, I'm gonna show something on the screen. I showed the guys before this, but I've seen like a few comments asking me if I'm doing this thing in Iowa. So give me like 3 seconds here, and I'll get it set up.
Oh my God, do we really have to watch this again?
Hey, go cry me a river.
I don't want to watch this. You sent me like 13 Snapchats of this already.
I sent you one Snapchat.
Well, it just kept replaying, I think.
What time did you send that? You sent that like at 1 o'clock last night, Mike.
Yeah, I was up late last night.
I woke up at 5, I was like, hey, a Snapchat from Andrew, what is this? It was a video, too. I was scared to play it out loud. I was like,
dude, Andrew and I were texting last night at about 1 o'clock.
Yeah, we were. All right, can you guys see this?
Unfortunately.
Yeah. All right,
watch this. You guys are going to be amazed.
It's back.
What?
The River City Hunting, Fishing, RV, and Boat Expo, January 15th through the 17th at the Mid-America Center. Over 100 exhibitors, demonstrations, seminars, and activities for the kids. Don't miss bass fishing expert Andrew Flair, Nebraska walleye expert.
Yo!
Yo, what is that?
I love the expert in there.
Expert? Alright, now we're back. Yo, how'd you guys like that? That was okay, here's the story on that. That commercial played during the Ellen show yesterday, like in like or like my local TV, and like a bunch of people started texting me and they're like, oh yeah, cool commercial, dude. And I was like, yo, what? I didn't know I was on a commercial. I thought it was kinda cool.
Wait. did any of us ask?
Peric? I sent your jealousy here? You need me to pipe down a little bit, because this is a proud moment for me, alright?
Alright.
It is pretty cool. Nothing compared to television.
It is pretty cool.
Don't bust his bubble yet. Wait till after the event. Let's see how good it goes.
Yeah, just wait till I get stage fright and don't want to do any seminars and stuff like that.
Crap your pants or something? Yeah, that would be
fun. Yeah. I shoot for the wrong seminar room, yeah.
Oh, goodness.
Let's see.
Isaac's thanking us for the shout out, so that's awesome.
No problem, Isaac. You're the man.
Yeah. Somebody asked me and Noah any advice on fishing Lanier. Fish the brush piles.
Yeah, brush piles definitely deep on Lanier. I mean, yeah, there's going to be some times where they're up shallow, but most of the time, I mean, they're out deep. When I was catching them before it got flooded, I was catching them in 40 to 50 foot of water on a fish head spin down the ditches. I have some videos over it. Actually, I just posted a video, I believe, like last week over it. But it's pretty crazy. I mean, those fish can get out deep, especially in that brush and in those ditches.
Yeah, and those spots are really, really aggressive. So you get it close, the strike zone is pretty big. So
especially if there's a lot of bait. Yeah, I'm near Alpharetta.
Yep.
Are you going to
the Southern Open in Gunnersville?
They have a Southern Open on Gunnersville this year?
Yeah, I'm excited. It's for high school.
Oh, I was like, what?
You got excited, didn't you?
All right,
I'm fishing that.
Here's a question for all of us, and we'll start with Flair. What are your plans this year? What are your goals?
Plans. I am going to fish college tournaments for the University of Nebraska, Omaha, which is where I live. Going to fish college tournaments. Going to work towards my marketing degree, stay in college as long as I possibly can, and continue to make videos, travel around, fish with all these awesome people that are on the screen right now. Me and Peric have fished against each other. Me and Noah fished against each other.
Yeah,
can't talk. What did you say? Who won? Shut up, Peric. but I want to fish with them, like in the same boat, on the same team, like, you know, just hang out. And of course, Fluke and Tyler and all. I want to fish with all the YouTubers just for
honestly,
fun.
Dude, I really think
just have a good year.
Even some smaller channels, I think we should get so like a lot of us and just have like a big tournament. I think that'd be really cool.
Yeah.
And then we all post like our perspective of the video. That'd be freaking sick.
Yep.
That'd be cool. The only
going back to my plans, hit 100,000 subscribers. Y'all need to help me with that. Woo! I think 1 year. So yeah,
basically maybe I'll subscribe.
51 weeks from now, I want to hit 100,000.
You know where I was at the beginning of this last year?
Huh.
I was at 48,000.
48? What? And I'm at 42?
Yep.
Hey. All right, it's possible then.
It is.
All right, you guys need to help me.
I just want to get like 5.
Hey,
I just want to get to 50.
You're growing. You're like 8 now, dude. You're
not me, dude. I'm a big shot now.
Hey, oh, anything over 5 and you're something.
I just need to get to 10. 10's the big hurdle.
10?
Yeah.
I just want the play button. I don't even care about the number.
Andrew, let me ask you this. Also, Flute, when did you guys what point as a subscriber mark do you think you hit to where it started to produce more?
Where it really just started to take off?
Yeah.
I couldn't even tell you. I mean, right December, I got more subs in that month than I have in my entire life in 1 month. So,
dude, Rod.
I don't know. One Rod's he's a different breed, dude. You can't even compare, honestly.
Me and Andrew were sitting at Nationals. One Rod was at 15,000.
I remember that, Noah. I remember that.
And Andrew was telling me about him. I never heard about the guy. And he was like, dude, this guy's gaining 1,000 subs a day. I'm like, what are you talking about? So we fish a few days of the tournament. We go back to another live stream. I refresh the channel. He gained 5,000 to 10,000 more. I was like, what the heck's going on?
We didn't know what was going on. But I would say I saw the most. The thing is, I feel like the more I get, the more I grow. Like I said, I had the most last month, and I have the most that I've ever had. So I think it's just the more you have. I'm sure, Fluke, you can say this too. When people see that 100,000 and they know you're about fishing and they like to fish, they probably subscribe. It just makes sense. I do that for any type of channel, no matter what it's about, hunting, fishing.
So if they have more, you feel more confidence.
Yeah, it's just peer pressure. And so I would say 5,000 is where I see, that's the hardest thing to do. If you can hit 5,000, you have potential. Not saying if you don't hit 5,000, you don't. But if you can hit 5,000, you have potential. I think you can grow to 100,000 subscriber YouTube channel within a few years. But 5,000 is kind of that mark that I look for.
You want to start, and they're like, all right, I'm going to hit 20,000 in the first 2 months.
No.
It's taking time. I don't know what One Rod was at. I don't know if you guys know what he was at.
At the beginning of last year?
How many years has he been on YouTube?
He's been doing it 1 month less than I have. But
no, he's been doing it about 3 years.
I had more traction than him in the beginning. I had more subs. I believe he had around 10,000 at the beginning of last year.
Yeah, he's been doing it serious for 2 years.
Wait, yeah. You've been doing it about 3.5 years?
I'm almost 4. He started in May of 2012, and I started in April of 2012, I believe.
Yeah.
Yours is April 21st. Mine's April 20th. Ours is a day apart is when, except you're a year ahead of me.
I'm a year before you, yep.
Andrew,
yep.
Remember when I started to dominate you in the beginning? And then
you did, dude. You don't know how pissed I was when you were dominating me. Because I go, the only reason why this AP basket is beating me is because he's friends with John B. I wish I was friends with John B. That was literally me, 3 years ago. And I was like, this is BS. This is BS. The only reason why he has subscribers rather than this. And then I met you at whatever the opens, and I was like, he ain't a bad kid. He ain't.
Nah, I'm just messing.
You're a good kid.
That's hilarious. But yeah, there's no magic number. There's no magic anything. My thought is, if you can get subscribers outside of your immediate family, you're doing pretty good. You know, it's just.
Can we answer this question? Ever fished private property? Yes.
John B has, because he's gotten kicked out.
I don't want to say what happened to me.
Me and John,
did you see that roast session that I put on that dude? Did you see that, AP, or any of you guys? Some dude was hating on John, and so I put up a Snapchat telling everybody to go bash on him, and it was literally thousands of comments within an hour just destroying this dude. It's pretty great. I was the power of Snapchat. Who would have thought?
Yeah. Well, let's go back to my question.
What's your question? Right,
what's your question?
What are your goals for this year?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. My goals. My goals?
Yeah.
Have any? Go on to Noah.
All right. Noah.
I'm kidding.
Go ahead. AP, just go.
Okay, I'm going. All right. My goal is to stay in college. My number one goal. Number two goal is to fish. To get enough money to fish one of the Ravaxes as a boater. I'm fishing two opens as a co. And then one as a co, and then I want to try and fish the second one as a boater. If not, I'm still going to fish as a co. And then I kind of want to keep fishing as much high school stuff as I can, keep on learning new lakes in the south, and keep on trying to post YouTube videos every Monday. And those are my goals. And be happy in life. That's another one of my goals.
Yep.
Keep your girlfriend happy.
Yeah, she'll be fine.
hey, Andrew, should I drop it on him?
Drop what?
I will go girlfriend say. Hey, AP.
Oh, yeah, go for it.
AP, don't waste your money on somebody else's wife.
If only I listened to you that 6 months ago, that would have been great.
Yeah. Who, you?
Me? If I would have listened to him 6 months ago, I wouldn't be where I'm at now in my financial position.
Are you going to get married soon, anytime soon?
Me? No, I don't plan on getting married anytime soon.
All right, we're about to get him in trouble. Noah, how about you, man? What are your goals for this?
My goals, I really want to build my brand more, build my name more, I guess you could say, build my YouTube for the most part, which, I mean, like we've just been talking about, it's going to take time, and it's just time to come, but definitely want to start off college good because I'm going to be starting in fall. I really can't wait for that. That's one of the biggest things, but also just progress in life, just general daily stuff.
Cool.
All right, what about you, Fluke? What are you doing?
Man, my goals this year, retire from my full-time job. That's number one. And my boss knows I'm getting ready to. Cool thing is, I've known my boss since I was 12 years old. So now we're 200 miles away, and he now pretty much he's in charge of me. But anyway, so number one, the second one is move closer to Lake Gunnersville.
That's a good one.
I'm going to be about an hour, probably about an hour and 15 minutes from Gunnersville, and about an hour and 15 minutes from Chickamauga. And so you see me a lot more videos there. Number three is do more kayak fishing videos. And then that's pretty much it. And get to the point where I'm launching a video every other day.
You want to get to every other day?
Every other day.
That's where I was in that – during the summer and spring, I was every other day for the most part. I'd miss a day, but it's a lot of work. But, I mean, obviously the problem is – all right, I'm going to go out and say it. John B. ruined this because he started doing all these fancy edits and everybody loved it. And so now I'm like, oh, now I got to start editing. So now I'm to the point where, like, putting out a video every day with the edits, you know, bringing the production value, it's definitely gotten tough. So I'm just going to put that on John B. right now. But, no, that's good, though, every other day. I think one rod's every other day right now.
He cuts the front and the back off and throws it on there.
Well, I know he doesn't edit, and he gets away with it, and it's amazing. Yep. He's a great guy.
Yeah, he is. My suggestion would be one video a week where you actually spend time editing.
Yeah.
And then the rest of them, I hate to call them filler videos, but videos where they aren't that special to you, you know?
Yep.
So, like the ones, I've got some coming out now where I just sat right here at the table and did some videos. And just however you can do it, or just fun videos or whatever, you know? We got to come up with new ideas where we can just have fun with them, you know?
Yep.
Yeah.
All right, guys, how long do you want to go? Do you want to go till 8:30?
Yeah,
well, I'm done. Basically 7 minutes.
Yep, 8:30.
Okay.
Do you want to all name our boats, since that question keeps coming up? I see it.
Name? Oh, like the brand?
Yeah, like what
I thought you meant, like name.
I thought you meant like giving a name.
Like, yeah, me too.
I think my next boat, I think I'm going to get some big sketches and put a name on the side. But
there you go. All right, we'll go down starting with you, AP. Noah. Sorry, I let you go first. Noah, you go.
I have a Ranger Zevi 20C, 2014. I had a 2008 before this, and then I got on the Ranger deal, the Ranger Pro stuff, and ended up getting a new boat, got a good deal on it. Really thankful for it. Really enjoyed my Ranger.
What engine you running?
250 show.
Sweet. I'm running a TR20, 2003. Was my grandpa's boat. And it's got the original 225 Optimax on there. No problems yet. And running two power poles and Lowrance now. Lowrance Electronics.
Nice. Fluke, what sweet setup you got?
My kayak is a Hobie Pro Angler 14. It's got a Lowrance 4X whatever chirp. And then for the electronics and the power pole micro on the back. Love that stinking kayak. And then my boat is a Alumacraft Pro 185. It's a 2015 model. Solid as a rock. I've got a 115 show. It's actually one of the very first 115s that came off the line, off the assembly line this year. and it is a wicked motor. It gets that boat up and going, and I don't have to worry about it. I'm at to about, with my 90 horse on my last motor, my 90 horse two stroke, I went. It cost me $40 a day to run, and my Alumacraft with 115 horse two stroke is, or four stroke, cost me about $20 a day.
Nice.
So I can run all day long. I figured it up. If I had a full size boat like Noah's that had like a Mercury two stroke on it, I would have spent $18,000 more this year on gas than I would have.
What? Gosh.
Yep. Don't even tell. What are you trying to do, man?
No. You've got a four stroke. I said a two stroke Mercury.
Oh, I thought you. I was like, what are you saying? No, but dude, on our old boat, we paid so much in like oil, and it was horrible. Yeah. We love the show.
My boat drinks oil.
Yeah, it's as fast as you guys can switch to a four-stroke, do it, man. It saves so much money, and those shows are incredible. So
I love mine.
I've got we'll see what I've got for 2016, but right now I'm running, or what I ran last year was a 1998 Bass Tracker 175 with a 50 horse on it. And I had two Hummingbird depth finders, and they were like the 580 series or something like that. Basically down imaging, no sight imaging. And got up to a crisp like 32 miles an hour. So I was blazing on the tournament trail, you know that.
Remember when you almost sank at Springfield?
I did. I did almost sink that boat. Thank God I didn't. That could have been bad.
Yeah.
One more question.
Prank call John.
Prank call John, yes. He called me. That was the person I answered. All right, I'm calling him.
Wait, when did he call you?
He called me, like, in the middle of the chat. I was like, yo. And
he's
like,
really?
He said something really offensive.
Now let's. I want to say something about John B. I am, and I've already told you guys about this, but I want everybody to know this, that John B. just got a job for Mystery Tackle Box, and I am so proud of him. He's actually going to be doing a lot of video work with him, photo work and things like that. So, dude, he's got a dream job right now.
Nature's big. I saw that video.
Oh, yeah. They did a Periscope yesterday, though. John, like, he was about to die. Tired.
He looked gone.
Yeah. Hey, mute AP while he's doing that, while he's talking to John.
We're ending in 3 minutes. That was terrible?
I don't know if I can mute AP. AP, mute yourself.
They want a speaker. Hold on.
Oh, okay.
Say, we want to just ask you one question.
What?
How much coffee have you gotten in the past 2 days at your job?
How much coffee?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you becoming an expert at the crew rig?
At the coffee rig?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can make like glass mochas.
I have this little cart that I push around.
A cart?
And it's got like decaf, caffeinated, cream. I got three different types of sugar, one of which is from Brazil. The MTB guys are super picky about their coffee, so I gotta have everything.
All right, you're getting cut off of live. I'll call you later.
Well, I think you need to cut this live off, man. This is passive.
All right, he's done.
That was gold.
All right.
I'm so jealous.
All right, guys, I'm about to fall asleep over here. All
right. We're gonna peace out, guys. So before we end it, all the links to Fluke Masters, Noah's, and AP, and then Tyler, who was on earlier, all the links to our YouTube channels are in the description. So check them out. Go subscribe to all of us. We make different videos, even though they may be about similar things. Each of us definitely put our own spin on everything, so you can learn something from each of us. And make sure to comment on all of our videos when you watch them. Give us support, and thanks for watching. I'm done.
You guys for watching, guys.
Yeah, we make the best YouTube videos, fishing YouTube videos out there, guys. So
check us out.
Thank you all.